Here is the transverse section of anther, and you can see the outermost layer of anther, which is epidermis. Just below the epidermis is a layer of endothelium. Below the endothelium, there are two layers, which are known as the middle layer, and the last one is the layer of tapetum, which is the innermost layer. And inside the tapetum, there is a mass of cells, which are known as sporogenous tissue, or this tissue has a lot of microspore mother cells, which are diploid, has 2n set of chromosomes in them. These cells has to undergo meiotic division, and by the process of meiotic division, each microspore mother cell is going to form 4 haploid cells. These are the microspores, and this is the story of microsporogenesis. Here in this diagram, you can see how the pollen grains are released after the rupture of the anther on the maturity. Here in this diagram, you can see the spiny outer structure of pollen grain with a prominent spot on the surface of pollen grain, which is known as the germ pore, through which this structure, which is called the pollen tube, it comes out while the pollen grain is germinating. Here is the you can see the germinating pollen grain with pollen tube. The pollen grain has two unequal cells. The larger one is called vegetative cell, which has abundant stored food material, and this cell is meant for the formation of the pollen pollen tube. And the generative cell is the smaller one with a spindle shaped nucleus. This nucleus undergoes mitotic division, and by the mitotic division, it forms two nuclei, and these two nuclei are the male gametes. This is all about the germination of pollen grain.